Hello students, good morning. Myself Dr. K.M. Khalkar, Assistant Professor, Department of Botany, KTHM College, Nasik. So friend, in the last lecture, we have already started this chapter, that is the methods of plant propagation. The plants are propagated by two ways, by two methods. The first one, that is the sexual propagation, which we have considered in the last week, and today we will start the next one type of the plant propagation, and that one is the vegetative propagation is there. We all know the vegetative propagations, a vegetative part of the plants. Vegetative propagation, the propagations which will be takes place by the vegetative parts of the plants are there. There are two ways of the vegetative propagation. The first one is the natural methods of vegetative plant propagation, and second one, like as the artificial methods, artificial vegetative propagation is there. Naturally, that part of the plants are modified and functions as a propagation part of the plant, known as the natural methods of plant propagation. We all know in FYBC we have considered this point, like as the runner is there, sucker is there, bulb is there, tuber is there, offset is there, etc. Bulbil is there. All these are the natural methods of vegetative plant propagation. But with reference to our syllabus, we will consider here only artificial methods of plant propagations are there, and there are four ways we all know, that are like as cutting is there, layering is there, grafting is there, and budding is there. And today one artificial methods of vegetative propagation which will be added there, simply we will say a tissue culture technology is there. So that these are the four or five types of the artificial methods of vegetative plant propagation. First, we will consider here what are the advantage of the artificial methods of vegetative plant propagation. The first one, a plant that cannot produce viable seeds such as the banana, seedless grapes and orange, etc., can be easily grown by vegetative methods of plant propagation. That is the one of the merit, one of the advantage of the vegetative methods of there. The plants which can't produce the seed, and if no seed, no sexual propagation is there. Such a type of the plants are propagated only by the method known as the vegetative propagation is there. The second one, it is easier, less expensive, and rapid methods of propagation is there. Yes, it is easier, less expensive, and the rapid method. By using a part of the plant, we will develop a number of the plants are there. With the help of the vegetative propagation, a genetically identical plant can be produced by this method is there. So genetically identical plants we developed by a vegetative methods of plant propagation here. The flower produced are the superior quality, means the plants which will be developed by vegetative methods of the plant propagation, it gives a flowers, and that flowers is of a superior quality is there, and the desirable characters of fruit can be maintained by a vegetative propagation. Yes, with the help of a characteristic of the fruits which will be developed on the plants, that will be maintained by these vegetative methods of plant propagation are there. All these are the merits, we will simply say, are the advantage of the vegetative propagations. There are few, we will say, the limitations are there, and that are, does not produce new variety. Yes, because of by the vegetative propagation, we can't develop the new variety is there, leads to overcrowding around the parent plant is there, leads to overcrowding around the parent plants. That is also the limitations or the disadvantage of the vegetative propagation, and very little possibility of dispersal. So dispersal mechanism is totally less here, or the very little possibility of dispersal which will be takes place by the vegetative methods of plant propagation. These are the three disadvantage, or we will say the limitations of the vegetative propagation. Then what are the types of vegetative artificial methods of vegetative propagation? Generally there we know the four types are there, like as the cutting, layering, grafting and budding. But one which will be newly added, or we will say a simple one, like as the tissue culture technology is there. First, we will, what is meant by this cutting is there. Cutting is a portion of the plant is cut, planted in soil, usually a stem, or it may be of leaf, it may be of root, and these cuttings are sometimes treated with hormone in order to induce the growth, and the new plant originate from the adventitious roots that grow from the cutting process is there. Second one, layering. In this, the stem of the plant is bent to the ground and covered with soil, and the adventitious roots are emerge from the plant parts covered with the soil, and this attach the stem with developing roots is known as the layer, and from the layer we will obtain a new plant is there, known as the layering is there. Grafting, we all know there are the two parts play an important role in grafting. One is the scion, second one is the root stock is there. The root stock, which is having a well developed root system and on which we can done the grafting by a superior quality plant part known as the scion. So the rootstock and the scion unite with each other and developed as a new one plant known as the grafting one is there. The budding means instead of the scion in a large part of the plant, we will taken scion in the form of bud and grafted on the rootstock. Generally, we will simply say a budding is there. So this is the, in this, a new organism developed from outgrowth, or we will simply say bud, and due to the cell division at one particular site, these buds develop into the tiny individuals are there, known as the budding is there. And newly added, that is the simple one, tissue culture technology. Grow it by a small part of the plant, maybe cell, maybe tissues are there, or maybe of embryo is there, maybe apical meristem is there, maybe lateral meristem is there, maybe embryo is there. We will develop a new plant, only the cells which is having a totipotency cell is there, and with the help of that, by giving artificial conditions of the, we will say the environmental conditions of the, we will say artificial soil is there, that is the media on which the cell is developed as a whole plant, known as the tissue culture technology is there. So these are the different five methods of artificial methods of plant propagation is there. First we consider here, that is the cutting. On the basis of plant part, relative position on the plant, cutting are classified into the four groups are there: stem cutting, root cutting, leaf cutting, and leaf bud cutting is there. The stem cutting, generally a cutting is done by this method, that is the stem cutting. A stem cutting is any cutting take from the main shoot of the plant, or any side shoot growing from the same plant or stem is there, and that the shoot with high carbohydrate content, usually root better is there. Means generally a part of the plant which will be taken for the purpose of propagation from the stem, which will contain a high carbohydrate is essential there, so that it gives a root system properly is there. And there are four type of the stem cutting on the basis of a nature of the wood is there, that are generally hardwood stem cutting, softwood stem cutting, semi hardwood stem cutting, and the herbaceous cutting is there. That is the nature of the wood. These are the four type of the stem cutting are there. The next one, that is the root cutting. In general, the plant which produced by sucker freely are easily propagated by the root cutting are there. Means which produce the suckers, they are generally developed or propagated by this method, known as the root cutting is there. A leaf cutting, that is the leaf which will be used for the purpose of propagated a plant is there, and that leaf cutting should preferably be preferred during the growing season, because buds if enter into the dormancy may be difficult to force to active stage and thereby inhibit the rooting in such a condition. So generally in the growing season, from the leaf cutting a developed seedling is there, a leaf which will be used there generally for the purpose. And last one, like as the leaf bud cutting, on the side of the leaf there is the number of the leaf buds are there, and that leaf bud if we are cutting and place into the soil, it will give a new seedling are there. So that one are the four type of the cuttings are there, like as the stem cutting, second one root cutting, third one leaf cutting, fourth one is the leaf bud cutting, and the first one stem cutting on the basis of wood, nature of the wood is there. There are four type of the, we will say, stem cutting is there. They are like as the hardwood stem cutting, softwood stem cutting, semi hardwood stem cutting, as well as the herbaceous stem cutting is there. All these are the types of cutting is there. So cutting is the one of the best method of artificial methods of plant propagation. Maybe it takes place by the stem, may by the root, by the leaf, or the leaf body is there. A simple process or the technology is there. Taking a select a healthy, wealthy diseased plant is there, from which select a proper stem is there, on which there is the need of a body is there, and cut it from the mother plant. Give a favorable condition, place into the soil, it will develop as a new plant is there, known as the cutting is there. The second one, a method is there known as the layering is there, and this method is also the one of the important methods of vegetative plant propagation, generally successful because the water stress is minimized and the carbohydrate and the mineral nutrient level are high here, and the development of the root on a stem while stem is still attached to the parent plant called as the layering. Here a development of the roots on the selected, we will say a branch of the plant is there, that will be still attached to the parent plants, the formations of the roots. Even when the roots are formed there, then we will detach it from the mother plant and develop it as a new plant, because of why a success rate is also more here. And the layer is rooted stem following the detachment from the parent plant and developed as a new plants. There are the different types, like as the simple layering is there, tip layering is there, as well as we will say the compound or serpentine layering is there, mound layering is there, and last one, air layering or the guti is there. Simple layering, the figure, it will simply give here what is meant by the simple layering is there, and this simple layer select a low growing, we will say, by bending a low growing flexible stem to the ground and cover a part of the stem with the help of soil is there. I make a small notch is there or wound is there, covered it with a soil, and we will say the apical part or the apex of the soil is of the plant is there above the soil. And when we will buried a part of the branch with the soil, in which there is the formations of the root, when the root formations are there, detach the branch from the mother plant and develop as a new plant, known as the simple layering there. Tip layering, the tip layering is also somewhat same like as the simple layering. A tip of the branch buried with the soil, after a few days automatically the tip is takes place the above ground of the soil, and nearby that there is the development of the roots are there, and such a type of the root developed part of the plant detached from the mother plant and developed as a new, known as the tip layering is there. Serpentine layering is also again like as the simple layering, only there is the serpentine, means select a healthy, wealthy, disease free climber, we will say part of the plant is there, or we will say a twig of the plant is there, and in a serpentine manner, means some part is buried, again open to the soil, buried, again open to the soil, with the help of a single, we will say, the branch of the plant, we will develop a tree to four seedlings are there, plantlets are there, known as the serpentine layering. And the fourth one, mound layering, it is useful with heavy stemmed closely branched shrub or the rootstock is there. Cut the plant back 1 inch above the soil surface in the dormant season, and in the favorable seasons that cut from the soil portion gives a number of the plants are there, seedlings are there. We will simply say towards the basal side there is the formations of the roots, means from the single plants we will develop a number of the plants are there by the simple, like as the mound layering is there. And the last one, the important one type of the layering, like the air layering, or that is also known as the guti is there. So air layering or the guti is different than the other four type is there. In air layering or the guti, instead of the branch coming towards the soil, soil goes towards the branch is there. Select healthy, wealthy, disease free branch is there. Then that branch remove the phloem portions of the plant branch about 1 inch in circular manner, and towards the wound, towards the, we will say, phloem remove portion, covered it with the help of sphagnum moss, watered it regularly. After a few days, the sphagnum moss a covered area of the branch of the plant, developed a root system is there, and that developed a root system branch cut from its mother plant and developed as a new plant, that is known as the air layering or gutti is there. That is one of the most important methods of the layering is there. The third one, methods of artificial methods of plant propagation, known as the grafting. The grafting is deeper than the cutting, and then the layering is there. Here grafting, the generally a grafting is form of plant propagation that consists of joining two separate plant part together to create a new plant is there. And the two separate plant part, the first one, that is the scion or the top of the branch, and the understalk, also called as the rootstock, which is the bottom portions with roots is there. So the bottom portions of the plant with roots, known as the rootstock, and the scion on rootstock, the part of the plant having a superior quality grafted on the rootstock, known as the scion, is there. In modern horticulture, it is used for a variety of purposes there. Why the grafting is done? For this following purpose: to repair the injured trees and to produce the dwarf trees and shrubs are there. To strengthen the plant resistant to certain diseases, a grafting is done there. To retain variety of characteristic, a grafting is done there. Or to adapt varieties of adverse soil or climatic condition, grafting is done there. At the same time, to ensure a pollination, a grafting is done there. All these are the various purposes because of why a grafting is done there. Then the next one point, the grafting is generally done between the related variety or species. Yes, that is the simple one. Means we cannot graft any part of the plant on the another plant is there. There is need a relative variety or a species are there. Means two species from a single genera, or the two variety from the single species are required there. Means on mango tree, which will we will only grafted a mango tree is there. Okay, so any one plant cannot graft on the any other plant is there. That required related variety and the species are necessary there. That is the important thing in case of the grafting. There are the number of the type of the graftings are there. Whip grafting, generally known as the simple grafting, tongue grafting, side or wedge grafting, in arching grafting, stone or the epicotyl grafting are there. So these are the various methods. Here in figure we will clear it. The first one we'll say, which will be given toward the left hand side upper corner, that is the simple or the whip grafting is there. A slanting cut which will be taken to the rootstock, slanting cut toward the scion. They are joined together in a such a way because of why a cambium is matched there, so that they are unite with each other and developed as a new plant is there. Instead of slanting cut, a tongue shaped structure which will be takes place there, known as the tongue grafting is there. Simply we will say. Next one, a side grafting, means toward the side of the rootstock the grafting is done there. A scion is grafted toward the side of the rootstock, known as the side grafting is there. In approach grafting, it's somewhat differ than the three ones are there. In approach grafting, it means here both the plants are rooted, but the two plants are having two varieties are there. We will simply say they are the stem or a patch of the stem, two stems are removed there. We will expose the cambium of the two stems are there. They are unite with each other, and with the help of that we will obtain a new plant is there. So that is the approach grafting is there. The last one, that is the epicotyl grafting, generally done in case of the mango tree is there. So epicotyl is also a success rate is high there. In the young one conditions, the means epicotyl means there is when there is the formation of the cotyl in young one stage, like as from the single seed development of the seedling is takes place there. In a formations of the seedling stage, we will do the grafting, and that success rate is very high. That is the epicotyl grafting, or also known as the stone grafting, generally do in case of the mango. Means from the seed there is a development of the seedling, at that stage we will done the grafting. A rootstock is there, scion is there, rootstock from the young one developed the seedling is there, and the scion which will be taken it from the improved variety of mango grafted on the rootstock, the success rate is high there, known as the epicotyl, or we will again say that is the stone grafting is there. The advantage of the grafting thing produce fruit quicker, means the formations of the fruits are very quicker is there, means from the seed developed plant, if it required 8 to 10 years for the formation of the fruit, in grafted plant that will be occur in 2 to 4 years are there. A tree grown from the seed may produce the poor tasting fruits are there. Grafting is then improve the taste and size of the fruits. Yes, because of high grafting, we obtain a quality of the fruit is there. A tree grown from the seed may be produce fruit the same as the tree seed came from the mother trees, but the grafted tree will just good as the tree cutting came from the sky and is there. Yes, means from the seed we will obtain same fruit is there, but from the grafting we will obtain a quality fruit is there, a scion character, whatever it may be, from that we will obtain the quality of the fruit is there. A grafted tree will continue to give the same quality fruits for many years. With the help of grafting, we will obtain a seeds more than 1 year, a same quality and the quantity we will maintain by the grafting is there. Grafted fruits trees can be sold to give income to the household is there. So more income we will obtain from the fruit which will be takes place by the grafting is there. By producing your own seedling and the fruit, we save money also. Means by the grafting we will save our the seeds as well as the fruits. Without the seed and the fruits, we will obtain a plant is there, seedlings are there. The seedling can be produced locally, saving time, etc. Because of why the grafting is there. So all these are the advantage of the grafting. And the last one method known as the budding is there. Budding, a modification of grafting is there. Okay, means instead of the scion is a part of the plant in the form of stem is there. Instead of the stem or the long stem, we will take a just bud is there. And that bud is grafted on the rootstock known as the budding is there. Budding, there are two types, a T or shield budding, and second one like as the patch budding is there. Means a T-shaped structure which we do, or the cut, a T-shaped cut is taken on the rootstock is there, in which a bud is inserted known as the T-budding is there. And if a patch is removed from the rootstock, a bark of the patch shaped structure is removed and the bud patch which will be tested on the rootstock, that is known as the patch budding is there. There are the three steps of budding, like as the preparation of the stock, preparation of the scion, and insertion of the bud on the scion is there. These are the three steps. With the help of that we will do budding is there. There are the two types of the budding, known as the T budding and the patch budding is there. And this one is the last point of this chapter, that is the advantage and disadvantage of the budding is there. So the few advantage, budding can be very well adapted to convert the inferior plant of the established tree into a superior one. Means the convert the inferior product into the superior one by the simple method known as the budding, by taken a bud from the superior quality, developed it on the inferior rootstock, we will obtain a superior product is there. Variety of establishment plant can be changed by the top working is there. Yes, with the help of that we will change the variety of the plant is there, and rootstock influence size, vigor of tree and quality of the fruits are there, and the rootstock impart disease resistant to the scion is there. And the disadvantage, Since single buds are not as strong as the stem section. Yes, when we are taking a stem, there is a number of the buds are there, and that are, we will say, very strong as compared to the single bud is there, and they are more susceptible to the environmental pressure. Even buds may interfere with successful budding by breaking of the buds as they land on the stem is there. If the buds, they are land on the stem of the budding stem is there, they may be disturb the bud, they may be fail the budding is there. So all these are the, we will simply say, the methods of the plant propagations are there, and the physiology and the anatomical basis, means when we can do the grafting, do the budding, there is need to match the cambium of the rootstock and the scion in a such a way that they are unite and developed as a new plants. So there is need a fleshy cut tissue cambium region match of both rootstock and the scion is needed there. Then nearby or toward the outer side, the parenchymatous cells are there. That too, the parenchymatous cells of rootstock and the scion must be joined immediately after joining the cambium. They form a single structure is there that is needed. That is the anatomical basis. Then and then only a formations of the root which will be takes place there. Then the next one, like as the differentiate into the new cambium cell, there is needed to develop it, form it, because of why they are unite very properly is there, and the vascular tissue development is needed to take place there, like as the xylem toward the inside, phloem toward the outside, and thus establishing the connection between the rootstock and the scion is successfully graft union, and because of why the success of the grafting or the budding is takes place there. So at the same time, the physiology of graft union shows certain chemicals which helps in good graft union between the stock and the scion is there. So the union of the rootstock and the scion, a special type of the chemical substance which will form air, with the help of that they are unite properly and developed as a new plant is there. So friend, here is the end of our second chapter, in which we have covered the different four type of the plant propagation, like as the cutting, layering, grafting and budding is there, their importance. At the same time, so we are considering the physiology of rooting is there. So these are the artificial methods of plant propagation. Thank you.